Welcome to Elite Expert Insider Podcast, where we will inspire, motivate, and educate entrepreneurs, innovators, and growth seekers. Brought to you by Elite Online Publishing, making the best and brightest in the industry number one best-selling authors. 80% of people say they want to write a book. We're assuming that's the same for you. If so, contact us at www.eliteonlinepublishing.com and make your book a reality. Hey everybody, welcome. It's Melanie Johnson. We have another great podcast for you here today. Please remember to subscribe to our podcast. We'd love to hear from you. Leave a note. And if you're looking to become an author and be a number one bestseller, reach out to us at eliteonlinepublishing.com. You can go right there. There's a contact form. Fill it out. We'd love to visit with you. So remember, if you're looking to write a book, just contact us, Jen and I. Hey, Jen, how are you doing today?
I'm doing great. Thanks. I'm so happy to be here.
Oh my gosh, we have such a terrific show. We have one of our favorite authors of all time on here. She's a number one bestseller in multiple categories. She wrote the book Free Mama, and she has the most unique following of awesome women that are in her group. So if you're a mom, you're a new mom, you're a mom of teenagers, and you're looking to get out of that working rut, and you want something new, you want to have that freedom, we're going to teach you how to do that today. So Lauren Golden is here today. She loves helping mamas find freedom from that 9-to-5 grind. She has launched the Free Mama Movement. She is a fearless leader. She has a community of tens of thousands of women who have followed her and gotten the freedom to work from home and have financial freedom. Lauren, thanks so much for coming today.
Thank you guys for having me. I'm so excited to just share the Free Mama message and reconnect with you guys. It's been a while since we've chatted, so I'm super excited.
Awesome. Well, tell us a little bit of your background and how you came to write the book and start the movement.
Yeah. So I always say, you know, a lot of times the businesses that you want to sell, something you're passionate about. My business actually started with a mission. And my mission is that no mom should have to choose between financial stability and her family. And so that was kind of the basis for my business, but also for the book. And so what's really interesting is that I grew up with a stay-at-home mom. That's what I thought motherhood would look like for me. Flash forward however many years, 25 years, I guess. And I got pregnant with my first child, and my husband and I never even had a conversation about that I would stay home. We both knew in the back of our head, like, but we know what our mortgage is. We know what we make. Like, that's just not happening. But soon after returning to my 9-to-5, I realized that I love working. But flash forward a few years later, I had two kids and I felt that pull that a lot of mothers feel. I started to feel really guilty that I was giving my best, my freshest hours to my 9-to-5. I didn't have a lot of control over my schedule. Like, I had to be at work when I had to be at work, and then my family kind of got what was left over, and that wasn't allowing me to be the mom that I wanted to be. And so I kind of went out on a journey, so to speak. I tried a lot of different ways to work from home. And it was freelancing that really stuck out for me. And just that idea of self-employment and being able to utilize whatever skills that you have or whatever skills you're interested in acquiring, and you can get paid for them. And when I realized that you can actually get paid more for them than you can make at your 9-to-5 job, and you can set your own schedule and pick the people you work with and all these different freedoms that I think people crave, I really knew I was onto something. And so that mission of moms not having to choose between being with their kids and providing for them, combined with this new business industry that I had kind of grown pretty experienced in, was the perfect kind of concoction for not just the book, but for the community, because I realized how many other women really craved this same kind of lifestyle that I had found for my own family.
So walk us through a little bit. Someone wants to, they've got new kids, or their kids are, let's say, 2 and 4 years old. They want to make that transition. What are some of the things that they can do to get started? Like, I have no idea what to do. I want to leave my 9-to-5. Lauren, how do I get started?
Yeah. And what's really interesting too with that question is that when I first started the Free Mama Movement, that's who I was talking to. I was talking to those people who were kind of a former version of myself. They had to work, right? Like, we need money. We have to work. But what I realized is this movement and this concept of being in control of your schedule while still making money, it's also really appealing for stay-at-home moms. And so I actually have a lot of different types of women who come into our community, and they all want something different out of it. They want to grow in their purpose and their identity and their confidence, and whether they want a little bit of play money for vacation, or they need to replace a six-figure career, it's possible through the world of freelancing. So it's really, really awesome. My advice to get started would be, to start to identify some of your skills that you have. It might be stuff you're already really interested in, or maybe stuff you're just really good at. I know my stay-at-home moms are always like, well, I've been out of a career for, a decade. I don't have any skills. And I'm like, oh, shame on you. Like, you are doing the doctor's appointments and the school visits and the lunches and the scheduling and the birthday party. Like, you are great at scheduling things. You're great at organization if you're a mom. Like, I think this is just a universal thing for moms. Like, we're good at this stuff because we have to be. And I think what people don't realize, especially with freelancing, is that we don't know what we don't know. And so when people come into my community and realize that they can get paid to check someone else's emails or manage someone else's calendar, their mind literally is just like, I'm sorry, what? And I'm like, yeah, that's a thing. Like, how cool is that? And so my recommendation, if you're just getting started, is either, take the skills you have, whether you've been an accountant or whatever that thing is, or you've worked in marketing, take that because it's low-hanging fruit. Or just identify the things that you're naturally really good at and start there. You can grow it into anything you want to be, but if you're looking for the fastest path to cash, choose those things that you're innately already good at because you're doing them in your life anyway.
Yeah, I love that you say that to start out because, I think a lot of people, like I would have loved to have a community like you when I started out and starting my online marketing and web design company about 15 years ago, but I didn't have that community. So I just kind of did the things that I thought I should do, but I knew I was already good at web design. I knew that I knew marketing. But I think a lot of times people say, oh, I'm going to be a freelancer. I'm going to start my own business and I'm going to learn everything about this instead of looking at what they already know. Right?
Totally.
They're already good at scheduling or they're already good at crafting or whatever they're good at. And then they can do that for their freelance job or their VA job or whatever you want to call it.
Exactly. And what I've learned is that sometimes we do that to hide too. It's like, well, I want to do that. And so I have to go learn everything about it before I could possibly get started. And I am a big advocate of being a lifelong learner and professional development. I love professional and personal development. A podcast for books, like what better personal development is there than being a reader, right? But that takes time. And it's also kind of holding you back from doing the hard thing, which for most women I found is the simple act of putting yourself out there and declaring that you're doing it. So I recommend starting with that low hanging fruit. Don't hide, get out there and just get started. Because if you can actually get paid by a client to acquire a new skill, isn't that better than you having to pay to go acquire that new skill? Like, don't have somebody else pay you to do it, right? Like, it makes so much sense.
I love that. And I love that I was looking at your Facebook page and one of the people that are in your movement, they came out and said, I'm making an announcement today. No, it's not that I'm pregnant. I'm not having another baby, but I'm starting this online business. That's what she was referring to. And she's like, I'm kind of afraid, but I think it's going to be okay. I just want to let everyone know. It's like she took that step to announce it, which is the first step of doing it and getting it out there. So, and you know what I love too, is that you have this system, this daily five that you talk about. Yeah. Talk about the system that you have.
Yeah. So the daily five goes along with my productivity planner, which we launched not long after my book came out. And this is a system that I've been using for years. It's something I teach in my program. I teach it to my moms because the truth is, like, we're busy. And I think moms in particular, whether you're working or you're not working, we just have more on our plate than the average human because we're taking care of other people's lives. Like, I don't know how we do it. We're superheroes. We find a way, right? But there's a difference between being busy and being productive. And I think a lot of women fall short here. They can stay busy. It's easy to stay busy and fill your time. But when it comes to when you decide and commit to start a freelancing business, you're going to have to take that seriously, right? Like, a business is not a hobby. You're in it to make money. So it has to become a priority, not necessarily more than your children. That's not what I'm saying here, but you have to create the time is something I say. It's easy to say, I'm too busy to do this. Well, you're not. You're prioritizing other things. So the Daily Five is my kind of productivity tool, so to speak, where you actually, every day, you're only going to come up with five things that you're going to do that day. And what's awesome about it is you don't even have to get all five done. So if you're listening to this and you're like, I'd be lucky to get two things done, like, it's okay. The goal isn't to get through all five. It's to teach yourself how to prioritize. So when you set your daily five, I recommend doing it the night before. You're actually going to rank the things on your to-do list in order. And the way that I want you to think about ranking them is in terms of shifting the needle forward. So for a lot of moms, it ends up being that scary thing, right? That putting yourself out there or coming up with something that maybe you would procrastinate because it feels hard, but you know deep down that it's the thing that you should be doing. So when it comes to the Daily Five, you're not allowed to procrastinate because you don't get to go on to numbers 2 through 5 until you've completed that first task on your list.
I love that. I love that. And I love the cover, by the way. If you haven't seen it, you can go onto Amazon and get the productivity planner, the Daily Five, and you can look that up with Lauren Golden. But I love it. And it looks so cute inside.
And of course, Elite Online Publishing produced it. We're very proud of that. So, and that's the other thing we want to know. I mean, obviously you had a great community before you came to us, but then you took that leap forward and you took that other step of becoming an author and knowing you wanted to become an author to share with those people in your community on a different level. So talk to us about that and your book and the process and how you've been using it and how it's changed your business.
Yeah. So I kind of went out of order as I was prioritizing, like we were just talking about, and figuring out what do I actually need and what's important and when. And I think those are hard questions to ask, especially when you're someone who's ambitious and you've got a lot of goals. I think it's important to step back and realize, like, I can do all of these things, but maybe I can't do them all right now. And what order does it make sense in? So I had actually started writing my book years ago, before I had even created my community, before I had built my online program. And it was kind of all these thoughts, which I feel like is why a lot of people write a book. It's like, I've got something to say. I have a lot of stuff going on. And so I started getting it out. And then I hit pause to start building my business, because the reality was, as much as I wanted to write this book, it was not my fastest path to cash. It wasn't going to be the thing to start my movement at that time. And I knew that very logically. So I put it on pause. I leveraged it. It was actually my first draft of my kind of like table of contents, so to speak, my first outline that became the framework for my 12-week online program that teaches moms how to freelance from home. So it's served its purpose in those early days. And then it was less than a year later that I picked it back up. So I started building my program the fall of 2017, and it was May of 2018 when all of a sudden I had kind of this online business machine built. It was built. My business existed. It worked even when I stepped away from it. And so that's when I knew that it was time to work on the book. Like, it was just this voice in my head of like, the book. And I'm like, okay, it's time. Like, I have the attention now. And the beautiful thing about doing it that way is that then I had the audience to launch the book to. And if I wouldn't have had that, I don't know that I would have had the same amount of success. And so as a business owner, not as an author, but as a business owner, I know that I made a really strategic decision by pushing pause, focusing on my business, getting kind of my systems and offerings in place, and then coming back and doing the book, which, yes, it was a passion project. It's something that has been, you know, bursting out of me for a long time, but it's also now a marketing tool. So it's now something that I can leverage to send people back to the thing that I worked really hard to build. And we were kind of chit-chatting before we started recording. What's really awesome is now it works even when I step away. Like, people in my community are so excited to get my book or find my book that they take pictures of it and they post it online. And so they're doing my marketing for the book for me. I had to do that initial launch with you guys, but since then it's like, it just, much like that business machine, the marketing machine for the book, I continue to be able to leverage it. And it's honestly been life-changing. It's so impactful, not just for me, but for the people who get to read it. And then, you know, to kind of see people wanting to share it is the coolest thing ever.
I love that. And I love that you have a great call to action in your book. Tell us about the clients that you've already got clients from your book. So tell us about that experience.
I have. And Jen, I want to give you credit here because you, I think, was the one who said it on one of our initial planning calls, where you were like, don't forget to seed them throughout the book. And it wasn't really something I thought about. I kind of knew I wanted to have like a last steps, kind of like, where do I go now? You know, we read a book, especially when it's motivational and we're excited, but I don't know. I'm kind of over the motivational speakers who hype people up and then don't give anything substantial to back it up on. That's kind of not what I'm about. I'm very like tactical and practical and in the weeds. And so I knew I didn't want to leave them hanging. I wanted to bring them into my community. I wanted to share with them my free resources. But Jen, you really planted the seed of like, you need to go back through your book and make sure you're doing it the whole time. Like, tell them where you want them to go. And it's interesting because that's something I teach in freelancing in terms of when we network and whatever, like you need calls to action, you need this, but I hadn't thought about doing it in my book. So that was really, really great advice. I think I got off track. Where was I supposed to be going
yeah,
with your
call to
question?
Action. Yep. Yeah. Also, how you got clients from your book, how it's used.
How I got clients from your book. So that's how I did it. That's how I did it. I seeded it through the whole book. And then I kind of summarized it at the end. I brought it all together of like, okay, if this spoke to you, if your wheels are turning, if you're excited, if you want some hand holding, if you want some support, like, and I literally, mine was very, again, because I'm very tactical. It was like resource one, resource, like step one, join my community. Step two, go watch this free training. Step three, like buy this product. Like I told them, if you want to be successful, if you want help with what to do after you read this, this is what you go do. And so we launched the book in December of 2018. And by January of 2019, so literally 1 month later, I had a woman who had enrolled in my group coaching program. And the only way to get to my group coaching program is to enroll in my 12-week online program. So this woman invested over $1,000. And on her first group coaching call, she told me in her introduction, because I have everybody introduce themselves because we're family. And I always kind of say like, what attracted you to the Free Mama? And she said, I read your book. I found your book on Amazon and I read your book. And I was like, like I had this moment of like, you know, I do a lot of advertising. I do podcasts. Like I do a lot of marketing, but that was the first time, and it didn't even take that long, where I saw it was automated. I didn't even have to step in at all to the process, and it worked. And not just that, yet from the business side, that's really exciting, obviously, the sale and whatever, but to know that someone, that the book worked, that someone was so touched by this thing that I spent months bringing together and pulling together and very strategically with help, obviously, you know, and that it then touched her enough that she wanted to do more with it. And that then I'm able to get to know her and coach her, like the transformation that she had to know that it worked from that capacity. I mean, that's everything. That's why we do what we do. So it was really, really a very cool moment.
That's awesome.
And I like how you say that it was like you didn't have your hands in the process. It's just Amazon promoted the book. She bought the book. She joined your community. And you're like, wow, that was just felt like it just falls in your lap.
Yeah, you just set it and forget it. We work hard to build. I think and that's kind of back to the business side again. It's how can I think strategically about what I'm doing? Like my whole life motto is like, I want to work smarter, not harder. And so again, the timeline of kind of how everything came together was so beautiful. And then now it just continues, you know, to grow from there without me even having to do much. So it's pretty awesome.
I love it. Well, tell us, what are you working on now? What kind of events and stuff do you have coming up?
Yeah, actually events is pretty much my big focus this year. So last year, after I had the program created, my big focus was the book. It was, you know, this, it had been important to me for a really long time. 2019 is all about events. So I run an online-based business. I work from home. I've been doing it for a long time. I'm a people person and I want to know my community and not just through the internet. So I've actually been traveling around to a different city every single month this year. I'm going to do it the entire year. We also just announced that we are going to be hosting a 3-day retreat in October in Houston. So events, literally, you hit the nail on the head. That is my focus. And it's how can I bring these women together in real life for even more impact and more connection and more community? Because I genuinely believe you can create friendships online, but there's something so powerful about that human connection. And I think a lot of people, we're missing it now in today's age where we can do things virtually, which is a godsend, right? It's yeah. How I run my business, but I want to bring it back to real life. And so that's been a really big priority for me.
Well, tell us where we can find you and people can get connected and become a free mama.
Yeah, come check me out anytime. My website is thefreemama.com. My favorite place to hang out is over on Facebook. I have a Facebook group with tens of thousands of women in it. It's the Free Mama Movement. And then I've gotten really big into YouTube this year. So I'm trying to reach more people. Again, YouTube, it's the second biggest search engine. So you can go, people are looking for this stuff. And so you can go look for me on YouTube. You'll find me. And I put out free trainings every single week. We call it Free Mama TV, and they come out on Tuesdays.
Awesome. Awesome. Well, thanks so much, Lauren, for being here. We'll put those links up at the bottom so people can see it when they're watching on YouTube. And if they're listening to this, they can just go to thefreemama.com.
Awesome. Thank you guys so much for having me.
You're welcome. And if you love this podcast, please subscribe to it. And if you would like to become a best-selling author and use your book for your business to get new clients and get a monthly check from Amazon every month for your book on royalties, hey, look us up at EliteOnlinePublishing.com and you can become an author too. We look forward to seeing you next time. Have a great week.
If you'd like to create the most powerful advertising tool for your business, contact us at EliteOnlinePublishing.com, where we will help you create, publish, and make your book a number one bestseller, and show you how to get new leads and more revenue for your business. If you'd like to check us out on our Facebook page, we have a free book for you as our gift. Just go and click free book. Remember to subscribe and leave a comment for our podcast. We would love to hear from you.